Hello, my loves. It's Monica, and today I am coming at you with a book haul, and it is quite a large book haul, to be honest. I did not think I had acquired this many books over the past few months. Really thought that I was in a book buying ban, but apparently not. Well, I do have some excuses. One, some of these books were sent to me by publishers, some of these were kindly gifted to me, and other ones were ones that I purchased at 3 a.m. when I was having anxiety spirals, and I think that's a valid excuse. Anyways, I am really excited for all of these books. These are basically the books that I am definitely hoping to read over the next couple of months. Yeah, all of them just sound so amazing to me. So I'm really excited to share them with you all. I'd love to hear from you guys in the comments down below which one of these sounds the most interesting to you, or let me know which books you're most excited to pick up this spring. Before I dive in, though, I do want to give a big thank you to this video's sponsor, which is Book of the Month. Book of the Month is a popular and fast-growing online book service for readers. Their mission is to promote new and emerging authors and help readers discover books they love. Here's how it works. Their team vets hundreds of books each month and gives readers their choice from a curated selection of new and early release titles. Plus, they have a fantastic skip policy where you can skip any month, anytime, and you won't be charged. One of the books I'm most excited for this month is Ariadne by Jennifer Saint. This is a story about the Princess of Crete and her role in the story of Theseus and the Minotaur. Jennifer Saint actually studied classics, so I'm especially excited to see her take on this tale. You can learn more about all of the month's picks in the link in my description box below. And finally, Book of the Month has the best price for new release hardcover fiction. You can get your first book for just $9.99 with the code MAYREADS. All right, so the first couple of books I purchased recently when I went to Barnes & Noble, which was a really exciting day. It was my first time going to a bookstore in over a year, and I was just so elated to be in a Barnes & Noble. It was like just such an exciting adventure. So I went there specifically to pick up Rule of Wolves by Leigh Bardugo. I already have a whole vlog up in which I read this book and react to it. So if you guys haven't seen that yet, I'll be sure to link it down below. I had a lot of fun filming that one and just like taking you guys book shopping with me, and then also, of course, reacting to Rule of Wolves. So would definitely recommend checking that video out if you haven't yet. So Rule of Wolves is the grand finale to the Grishaverse. Lee has said that while she is open to the idea of writing more books, particularly about the crows, that this for now is basically the end. And it is such a perfect ending. I really can't speak to anything that's going on in this book because it's just massive spoilers. And honestly, like King of Scars is so fun to read and experience and just like get all of those surprises. So I would never want to spoil anyone on it, but yeah, I love this series, and Rule of Wolves, after reading this, became my absolute favorite in the entire Grishaverse. I just think it's a masterpiece, honestly. So also during that Barnes & Noble trip, I got really excited and I ended up purchasing two additional books. The first one is Late Night at the Telegraph Club by Melinda Lowe. This was one of my most anticipated books of the year. I talked about it at the beginning of the year in that video, and I am so excited to own it. This book takes place in San Francisco's Chinatown in the 1950s, and we follow an Asian main character who is also a lesbian, and it explores sort of what her experience is like growing up queer during this time period and in this particular place. And it also, I believe, explores a lot of like the Red Scare and like the fear of communism. So really, really intrigued to read this one. I've heard absolutely brilliant things about it. Then I picked up Yolk by Mary H.K. Choi, and Mary H.K. Choi is one of my absolute favorite authors. All of her books destroy me in just the absolute best way. So I'm really excited to own this one. I've been kind of working my way to reading it emotionally because I know that I just know it's gonna destroy me. But basically, this is about two sisters. One of them, I believe, gets diagnosed with cancer. I think they have a bit of a difficult relationship, but they end up moving in together after the diagnosis. And that's really all I know going into it. She just, I feel like, writes in this way that for me is so relatable and feels so honest. And I love her writing so much. And also, this is one of the most beautiful, like, book designs. I love it. You have, like, the two girls and then their hands connect on the pages. I just think that's stunning. So, yeah. Now we're gonna get into the books that I purchased during some anxiety spirals. Love that for me. The first one is Jade City by Fonda Lee. So I picked this book up because I ended up reading these Violent Delights and I didn't love it as much as I was hoping to, unfortunately. But I've heard such amazing things about this one. And one of the things that I really wanted more of in these Violent Delights was like that sort of gangster mob story. And so that is what this one is also about. So I was like, okay, well, I'll try this one. And I've heard such amazing, amazing things about this one. This is a fantasy. I believe this one in particular follows four siblings of this empire who are each vying for control of it. So I'm really intrigued for that and just like the dynamics of those relationships. Yeah, I'm really excited for like a gritty fantasy. And also I've heard that this is getting adapted. So that is very exciting. We love to see it. This next book I picked up because of Chandler from over at Chandler Ainsley, and that is Eden Brooke. So Chandler gives such fantastic romance recommendations, and she talked about this one and just talked about how like cute it was and fun to read, and I was like, yes, okay, I'm in the mood for something cute and fun to read. And she also, I believe, compared it to like Jane Austen-y. Maybe like sort of it's a Regency romance basically. And it does sound really just so quaint and lovely. So I'm really excited to read this one. Basically, we follow a girl who goes to the countryside because she thinks she's going to like find peace, but instead it's just like constant mishaps. So yeah, I'm really excited for that. And this is one that I've heard just like good things about for a while. So I've been excited to pick it up. That one was definitely a 3 a.m. anxiety buy because I was stressing and I was like, you know what? You know what sounds like it'll soothe me? Eden Brooke. Then I picked up The Blood Spell by CJ Redwine. I love Cinderella stories. It's a thing, especially in Korean dramas. Oh my gosh. Cinderella stories are everything. So yeah, I love Cinderella stories and I love when people take or give new life to that tale. So that is basically why I picked this one up. In this one, we follow Blue Delacour, who has magic, but she tries to hide it. But then her father is mysteriously murdered and she ends up being in control of this like basically her evil stepmom. And so she has to turn to the one person who she's hated her whole life. We love to see it. And he is, of course, a prince who also needs to find a wife. Again, we love to see it. So yeah, this one just sounds like a fun, cute romance. And again, I love Cinderella. I love Cinderella retellings. I just think they're the best. So I'm excited for this one. So then I also ended up picking up Ash by Melinda Lowe because I didn't own a copy. I feel like it's one of those like definitive YA titles. And I also like, I'm planning on reading Melinda Lowe's newest book. So I just thought it'd be a good idea to pick up her first, or is this her first? I feel like at least it's her best known book outside of her newest one. So I'm really excited to fall into this one. Then I was kindly gifted a few books that just honestly made my day. A couple of these arrived on like really hard days for me. So it just meant a lot to the idea that someone thought of me. I don't know. It was just wild. Obviously, like there is never any pressure whatsoever to like join my Patreon or, you know, buy something off my wish list. Like that's just there because I get asked for it a lot. And so I just figured it was easier to post it just like talking to me on Instagram or in the comment sections of my videos. Like that alone means the whole dang world to me. But I do want to say a special thank you to the people who did send these my way. The first one, not all of these though, came with like a little thing that said like who it was from. So if I don't mention you and you sent one of these my way, please let me know so I can thank you properly. But the first one is Mooncakes. This one is one that didn't come with a little card that said who sent it my way, but I've been wanting to read Mooncakes for so long. My friend Francina read it and just absolutely loved it, and it's been out of stock for so long. I didn't even realize it was back in stock, so I was hyped when this arrived. But yeah, this is basically a sweet romance graphic novel with a supernatural twist, and it just sounds absolutely lovely. And I've been really excited to read it for so, so long. So yeah, I'm really hyped that this arrived at my doorstep. So this next one came with a note, but no name. So again, if this was from you, let me know. But it's My Brother's Husband by Gengora Tagame. And this is a manga about a man who moves in with his boyfriend's brother because his boyfriend has passed away. And so hence the name. So this book is supposed to explore a lot of what it means to be queer in Japan, especially a gay man in Japan. And I've heard it's absolutely amazing. People love this manga, so I'm really excited to read it. This person also sent me Bloom, which is another gay romance manga, but it is all the way over there. But here it is right here, because I can't move. There's so much stuff here. I'm currently doing some room stuff, so it's a little bit of a disaster. I'm actually almost finished with Bloom, and it's so, so sweet. It is such a good, like, summer romance kind of read. And then I was sent The Making of Asian America by Erica Lee, and this is a history book that I've been wanting to get my hands on for a while. Obviously, just learning about Asian American culture and history is really important to me because it's not really something that we get taught. So this was so thoughtful, the fact that someone thought to send this my way. Again, I don't know who it was, but I'm really excited to read it. I've been dipping into it a little bit at night, and it's fascinating so far, but I will be sure to update you guys and let you know how I get on with it as I continue reading it. It's not really one that I'm planning on like getting through really quickly. I kind of am wanting to go through it pretty slowly and like really digest everything that I'm reading. But yeah, I'll definitely keep you guys posted on this one. Okay, this next one low-key made me cry. And that is Save the Cat by Blake Snyder. And this was sent to me by Cleo. And the note said something to help you with the writing endeavors. And I cried. That's just like the nicest thing. I'm so excited for this. If you're not familiar, Save the Cat is a really beloved book that a lot of writers use, both writers in the like book sense and obviously the script writing sense, because it is a screenwriting book originally. But yeah, a lot of writers use it as a reference for when they're drafting, and it has been super helpful for me. And I'm hoping to do some like writing vlogs either here or on TikTok or both. We'll see. But yeah, I'm just so incredibly thankful and floored that anyone would want to send me a book at all, let alone something like this. And then lastly, I was sent Everything Belongs to Us by Eugen Grace Wirtz. And this was sent to me by Oscar, who also wrote just like the kindest note. I'm really excited for this one because this is a novel that follows two Korean women in 1978 Korean who are at university. And this time period is one of great transformation for Korea. And I'm just really excited to explore that through a novel. So yeah, and also this is such a beautiful cover. I just am in love with it. Oh, I did have another novel that I bought during a 3 a.m. anxiety spiral. and it's The Court Dancer. I might have talked about this actually in a recent video. I think in my what I want to read this season video, I think I talked about this one, but basically it's a Korean historical novel. This one takes place during the Joseon era in Korea, and we follow a famous Korean dancer who ends up traveling to Belle Epoque France. Wait, why did I say it like that? And this one is supposed to be a meditation that forces people to confront the double-edged swords of tradition and modernism. So I'm really excited for this one. I love historical fiction, and I especially love Korean historical fiction. So hyped for this one. I'm probably gonna read quite a few of these over the next like month or so, because I want to have more books to talk about when Koreatathon rolls around. And I'll have like a proper Koreatathon video coming up in the nearest future, so keep an eye out for that. So these next few books were ones that I was sent, and I'm so excited for all of them. The first one is Witches Steeped in Gold by Shannon Smart. This was another one that was like one of my most anticipated books of the year. But in this book, we follow two girls. One is the heir to an overthrown dynasty that was magically gifted, and the other is, I believe, one of the daughters of The dynasty that ended up taking over, or the rulers who ended up taking over and also stealing the magic. And so they hate each other, but they end up having to come together to fight one woman who is trying to destroy everything. So excited for that, really intrigued for that dynamic, especially between the two girls. Then I've said How We Fall Apart, and this one is a YA thriller that is Crazy Rich Asians meets One of Us Is Lying. And I also think it's supposed to have like dark academia vibes. So I'm excited for that because I haven't read a dark academia with like Asian people in it, I think, at all. So that's exciting for me. Would love more. If anyone has recommendations, please let me know. And then these next books were all sent to me by Simon Teen. So the first one is The Infinity Courts, and this one, this cover, first of all, like it's stunning. But this one sounds so fascinating. So I'm really excited for it. Basically, we follow a girl who has like, just is really excited about life. She's on her way to a party. She just graduated, I think, high school. Yes, just graduated high school, but then she gets murdered and she goes to the afterlife, and there she enters the Infinity Courts. And at the Infinity Courts, she realizes that an AI assistant that people on Earth love, or people in like the living world love, has basically become this overlord of the afterlife. So I think it's supposed to be like sci-fi-y, but like also fantasy-y because it's in the afterlife. I don't know, it sounds really cool. I love technology in books, and just like the way I love like books exploring technology, especially like YA or ones written by women. So yeah, I'm really excited for this one. Then I got The Cost of Knowing, and I'm really excited for this one. It sounds super interesting. Basically, our main character, when he like comes into contact with someone, he sees like a moment in the future, and he ends up seeing his brother being murdered. And the blurbs on the back of this one make it sound so fantastic. One is from Lamar Giles, and they wrote, "The Cost of Knowing is a tense and timely portrayal of powerful black boys growing up too soon with knowledge that the past and future are aligned against them." Morris writes, the best kind of speculative fiction, the kind where reality is close enough to touch. And then the last book I'm so excited for, and that is In Deeper Waters by F.T. Lukens. This was another one of my most anticipated books of the year. And in this one, we follow a prince and pirate who fall in love. It's a romance. And I, a while back, read F.T. Lukens' The Rules and Regulations for Mediating Myths and absolutely adored it. It was just such a fun, like, I would compare it almost to like if you took Buffy and mixed it with Simon versus the Homo Sapiens Agenda. Like, that is that is that story. Like, it was just really funny, but also it had like this very great contemporary like feel to it that I just was totally enthralled by. So I've been really excited for this one. Because it just sounds really fun and cute, and also, oh my gosh, like, if we're gonna talk about covers, this is definitely one of my favorite covers of the entire year. I'm just like, look at that. Look at how amazing that is. So yeah, those were all the books that I acquired recently. If you made it to the end, leave a little unicorn emoji so I know. I'd also just love to know what books you've recently acquired or are most excited to get your hands on. And once again, thank you to Book of the Month for sponsoring this video. I'll talk to y'all next time. Bye.